Hello friends, this is Professor Umesh and you are watching Made Easy Solutions. Up till now I have uploaded total 9 videos on my YouTube channel. First 4 of them based on number systems and next 4 of them based on number system conversion. And the last one based on measuring units in digital electronics. So up till now you are well familiar with number systems. Why we use various number systems in digital electronics? Why we use numbers in place of signals? How we can write numbers in different number systems? What are the basis of different number system? Also, you know how to convert numbers from one basis to another. So now you are ready to learn new concepts. So from today onwards, we are going to start a new series of lecture based on number system arithmetic. Here you will learn how to add, subtract, divide, multiply numbers from different number systems. So today we are going to learn addition arithmetic. Here in this lecture, you will learn how to add numbers in decimal number system, in binary number system. So let's move forward and start out today's lecture.
So friends, as we have discussed in the introduction just few minutes before, today we are going to learn the addition arithmetic, that is addition in decimal number system and addition in binary number system. So let's move forward. So friends, first we will learn the decimal addition. You may ask me that, sir, why to learn decimal addition? We have already learned it from our childhood. It's okay friends, you know decimal addition very well, but here we will just recall the decimal addition so that it will be easy for you to understand the addition operation in binary, octal and hexadecimal number system. So here we will work on possibilities, and let's check the first possibility. Our first possibility is two digit addition. That means how we add any two digits in decimal number system. So we follow a basic formula of addition. Let's see. The first digit we use in two digit addition, we call it as a adder. And what the adder do? It adds the next digit to itself, and the result we get, we call it as a sum. And we use this sign known as plus sign to indicate the addition operation. And our next digit is known as addend. Addend is what? It is the digit which is get added into the first digit, that is adder, and the operation is shown by this plus sign. This sign is known as an equality sign, and it shows the equality of the both sides of the equation, that is left hand side of the equation and right hand side of the equation. So adder plus addend is the left hand side of the equation, and sum is the right hand side of the equation. And sum is what? The result we get after performing addition of adder and addend, we call it as a sum. So this is a basic equation we use in decimal addition. Now let's see some examples. Now here the adder can be from 0 to 9 and addend can also be from 0 to 9. So total possibilities will be 100 over here. So we will consider some possibilities. So let us consider adder is 0, which will add the addend 1, and we will get the sum as, how much the sum should we get? How we perform the basic addition which we have learned in our childhood? We either consider sticks, we either consider fingers of hands, remembering. So let us consider the adder as a fingers of right hand side, and let us consider the addend as a fingers of left hand side. So here adder is 0, so don't consider any finger from right hand, and consider only one finger from left hand, and now count them. So now after counting we get 1, so the sum we get here is 1. Now let us consider the adder as 5 and the addend as 4. So now consider 5 fingers of right hand and 4 fingers of left hand and count them. So what is the count we get? We get 9 as the count. So result will be 9 over here. So this is how we perform two digit addition in decimal number system. Memorize this concept, will require in future slides, or while we will learn now addition in other number systems. Now let's see next possibility, that is two digit addition with carry. That means sometimes the sum we get is more than the highest digit used in decimal number system, that is 9. So what to do in that case? Let's see. So how we will perform this addition? We have again a equation. So here we have a adder which adds the digits to itself and plus sign to indicate the addition operation. We have the second digit as a addend, which is get added into adder, and we consider carry from previous addition operation. If the carry is generated in the previous addition operation, we have to add the carry in current addition operation. So this is our left hand side of our equation, and our right hand side of the equation is sum. So this is how we perform the two digit addition with carry. And now let's see the examples. So 3 is my adder over here and 5 is my addend, and I have a carry 1 generated in previous addition operation. So I will have to add this carry into this addition. So now how will I add? Consider fingers from right hand as a adder, consider fingers from left hand as addend, and consider finger from right leg as a carry, and now count them. So what we will get? We will get the count as 9. So the sum I should get here is 9. Okay, I have got the sum as a 9. Let us consider one more example. So here 5 is my adder and 7 is my addend, and I have carry as a 1 generated in previous operation. So now let's add these 3 digits by considering the fingers of corresponding hand and leg and count them. So what I will get over here? 5 plus 7 is equal to 12 plus 1 is equal to 13. Now it is not a digit, it is a number. That means we have got the sum which is larger than the largest possible digit, that is 9. So what to do over here? Here we consider this 3 as a sum of that current addition and this 1 as a carry for next addition operation. Okay, this is the principle we use in decimal addition. So now let's see some examples. So here we will add 2 numbers with carry. Now I have arranged the equation in vertical manner: adder plus addend plus carry from previous addition, and finally we will get the sum over here. So let's consider the adder as 5789 and addend as 6854. Now the third row will show you the carry generated in previous operations, and we will add the carries to corresponding next digit, and we will get a sum over here. Now how we add? We start addition from LSD, least significant digit. So we will add first 9 and 4, and we will call it as a sum 0. So 9 plus 4 is equal to what? 13. So now what we will do over here? We consider 3 as a sum of this current addition and 1 is carry for next digit addition. So 3 is a sum over here and 1 is a carry for next digit addition. Now add the next digit, that is 8 plus 5 plus this carry, we will call it as a sum 1. And what should we get over here? 8 plus 5 is equal to 13 plus 1 is equal to 14. So sum 1 should be 14 over here. So now here 4 is the sum of this addition and 1 is the carry for the next digit addition. So I will place 4 over here and 1 is the carry for next digit operation. So now add this 7 and 8 along with this carry, we will call it as a sum 2. And what should we get? 7 plus 8 is equal to 15 plus 1 is equal to 16. So I have got sum 2 is equal to 16. So now consider this 6 as a sum over here and 1 is a carry for next addition. So I will place 6 over here and 1 is a carry for next addition. So now add the final digit, 5 plus 6 is equal to 11 plus 1 is equal to 12 is the sum 3 we get. So now here place this 2 as a sum and 1 is a carry for next addition operation, but now there are no next digit. So just put this carry as a sum. So thus we get the sum over here, and thus we follow the procedure. Now it is not mandatory that every time we have to add only 2 numbers along with carries. Many times we have to add more than 2 numbers. So let's see how we can add more than 2 numbers along with carries. So here we will add more than 2 numbers along with carry. So I have arranged the equation in vertical manner, and I have 2 add on over here, add on 1 and add on 2. You can have multiple addends. So let's see how we will perform the addition. So I have a adder 559.3, I have considered the fractional decimal number here, so that the addition of fractional decimal number will also be clear to you. My first addend is 896.7, my second addend is 397.8, and the fourth row will show you the carry generated in previous addition operation, and that we will add in the adder and addend, and finally we will get a sum over here. So now again let's start the addition. Now first add the fractional digits and we will call it as a sum 0. So 3 plus 7 plus 8, we will get sum 0 as a 18 over here. Now consider this 8 as a sum of this current addition and 1 is a carry for next addition. So 8 is a sum over here and 1 is a carry for next digit addition. So now perform this 4 digit addition. 9 plus 6 is equal to 15 plus 7 is equal to 22 plus 1 is equal to 23, we should get in sum 1. So here 3 is the sum of this addition and 2 is the carry for next addition. So 3 is the sum and 2 is the carry for next addition. So now perform the next digit addition. 5 plus 9 plus 9 plus 2, we will get sum 2 as a 25. Now place here 5 as a sum and 2 as a carry for next digit addition operation. Now perform the final digit addition operation, that is 5 plus 8 plus 3 plus 2 is equal to, we get 18. Now place 8 as a sum over here and 1 is a carry for next digit out addition operation, but there is no next digits. So consider this carry as a sum over here, and this is how we perform decimal addition. So let's start with binary addition. Now here we have to follow the same basic principle of addition that we have seen in decimal number system. That means we have at least two digits and we have to add one digit into other, and the result we get we call it as a sum. So my very first possibility is two digit addition. Now here, as we have seen in previous video, that symbols used in binary number system is called as bit. So here now we will say it as a bit, not digit. So my very first possibility is 2 bit addition. So here I have a adder and addend, and the result I will get, I will call it as a sum. So now as here we are considering binary number system, only 2 bits we have, that is 0 and 1. So I will take all the possibilities because only 2 bits are there, and the possible combinations of adder and addend will be 2 power 2 is equal to 4. So I will consider all the possible combinations as adder and addend, and we will see what sum I will get over here. So here let's check the first possibility. My adder is 0 and my addend is also 0. So what I will get? 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. So I am getting sum as a 0 over here. Now let's check the next possibility. Now if you know how to write the binary numbers, you will easily understand the next possibility, because 2 power 2 is equal to 4 possible combinations I can write over here, that are known as crumbs. We have seen in the video based on measuring units in digital electronics. Also we have seen how to write binary numbers in the video based on binary number system. So if you have not seen, if you are watching this video directly, then I will recommend you to watch the two videos first. So let's check the next possibility. Let my adder be 0 again and my adder be as a 1. So now here, if these two digits are in decimal number system, then 0 plus 1 is equal to 1 I will get. So in binary I should get binary equivalent of 1. Now binary equivalent of 1 is also a 1 over here, so I will get sum as a 1 over here. I am getting the sum as a 1 over here. Now let my adder be 1 and my addend be 0. So now here again 0 plus 1 is equal to 1 plus 0, we know that. So again I will get the sum as a 1 over here. Now let's check the final possibility, that my adder be 1 and my addend be 1 also. Both my adder and addend are 1 now. So what I will get over here? Remember, if these two digits are in decimal, then 1 plus 1, I should get 2. So, binary equivalent of 2 is 1 0. So, I get 1 0 as a sum over here. Now, what I consider over here, this 0 as a sum of this addition and this 1 as a carry for next addition. So, now as there is a carry in picture, we must see 2 bit addition with carry. So, let us see how we will perform 2 bit addition along with carry. So, now here I have a adder that will add addon in itself and a carry along with addon generated in previous addition operation, and we will get the result as a sum. So, now I have 3 bits to add, that means I am using 3 sets. So, 2 power 3 is equal to 8 binary numbers I can write, that means 8 possibilities are there. So, let us check all the possibilities one by one. So, let my adder be 0 and my addon be also a 0 and my carry generated in previous operation is also a 0. So, 0 plus 0 plus 0, I will get sum as a 0 over here. Now, let us check the next possibility. Then, if you remember the table or if you remember the binary numbers I have written when I had considered 3 sets in the video of binary number system, and you will know that the next possibility or the next number, binary number, will be 001. That means my adder will be 0, addon will be 0, and carry generated in previous operation will be 1. So, let us check. My adder is 0 over here and my addon is also 0 over here, and my carry is 1. So, now what I will get over here, the sum will be first 2 digit if I added 0 plus 0, I will get 0, and that 0 plus 1, I will get 1 as a sum over here. So, if you come across such addition, then consider the sum as a 1. Now, let us check the next possibility. If you remember the table again or the binary numbers of 3 sets, that means a 3 bit binary number, then you will find that the next possible combination or the next binary number is 010. That means my adder will be 0, addon will be 1, and carry will be 0. So, let us check. My adder is 0 and my addon is 1 and my carry is 0 over here, and it will give me the sum of, first check the sum of this adder and addon. So, if I add this adder 0 with addon 1, I will get 0 plus 1 is equal to 1, and then I will add this result 1 with the carry, that is 1 plus 0, I will get 1 over here. Now, let us check the next possibility. If you remember the binary numbers, you will find that the next possibility or the next combination is 011. That means my adder will be 0, addon will be 1, and carry will also be 1. So, let us check. My adder is 0 over here and my addon is 1 over here along with 1 carry. The sum will be, first check the addition of adder and addon. So, 0 plus 1, I will get 1 over here. Now, add this result, that is 1, into the carry. So, 1 plus 1, I will get 1 0. Now, here 0 is the sum of this addition and 1 is the carry for next addition. So, whenever you come across such situation while performing binary addition, consider 0 as a sum of this addition and consider the 1 as a carry for next addition operation. Now, let us check the next possibility. The next possibility will be 1 0 0. So, my adder will be 1 over here and my addon will be 0 over here along with a 0 carry. It will give me the sum of, first check the sum of adder and addon, that is 1 plus 0, I will get 1 over here. Now, add this 1 to the carry, that is 1 plus 0, I will get 1 over here. Now, let us move forward to next possibility. Our next possibility is 101. That means my adder will be 1, addon will be 0, and carry will be 1. If you are getting confused, just watch the video of binary number system, how to write 3 bit binary numbers. You will find that we get 101 after 100. So our last possibility we have seen was 100. That means adder was 1. You can see over here, adder was 1, addend was 0, and carry was 0. So my next possibility will be 101. So let's check. Adder is 1 over here, and I will add it to 0 addend, and my carry will be 1 over here. This will give me the sum. First add, adder and addend. So adder and addend, that is 1 plus 0, I will get 1 over here. Now add this result 1 to the carry 1, that is 1 plus 1, I should get 10. So I am getting 10 over here. Now again, 0 is the sum of this addition and 1 is the carry for next bit addition. So now let's check the next possibility. Next possibility will be 110. That means my adder should be 1, addend should be 1, and carry should be 0. So here my adder is 1, and I will add it to the addend 1 along with 0 carry. It will give me the sum. So first check the addition of adder and addend. That means 1 plus 1, I will get 10 as a sum over here. Now add this sum to the carry. So 10 plus 0, I will get 10 as a sum over here. Now the final possibility is all ones, that is adder, addend and carry will be 1 over here. So let's check. Adder is 1 and the addend is also 1 along with carry generated in previous operation is also 1. And it will give me the result. Can you guess the result over here, my friends? See here. So if these digits are in decimal, then 1 decimal plus 1 decimal plus 1 decimal is equal to 3 decimal. So I should get binary equivalent of 3 decimal, and binary equivalent of 3 decimal is 11. So I should get 11 as a result over here. So first check the addition of adder and addend, that is 1 plus 1, I will get 10. Now add this 10 to 1. So while adding, this 0 will be added with 1. So the result will be 1, and this 1 is the next bit. So I will get 11 over here. 1 is a sum of this addition and 1 is carry for the next bit addition. So this is how we perform 3 bit addition. Now let's move forward with practical examples. So here I will add 2 numbers with carry. So let's check how to add. I have arranged the basic equation in vertical manner. That is adder plus addend plus carry is equal to sum. So let's check with the practical addition. My adder is 1101. My addend is 0111. Now I will add the carry generated in previous operation along with the addend with the adder. The carry will be shown in this row. Now I will have the sum over here. So now let's add as we have done in decimal addition. That means start the addition from LSD addition, that is least significant digit. Here this one and this one are the least significant digits of adder and addend. Let's start with the addition of this 1 and 1, and we will call it as a sum 0. So 1 plus 1, I should get sum 0 as a 10. So here now this 0 I will consider as a sum of this addition and this 1 as a carry for next addition, next bit addition. So 0 is the sum of this addition and 1 is the carry for next bit addition. Now perform the next bit addition, that is 0 plus 1. So I will get 1 over here, and now this 1 will be added with the carry. If you remember the 3 bit addition process just we have seen on the previous slide. So first 0 plus 1 will be 1, and then the result 1 will be added with this carry 1. So 1 plus 1, I will get sum 1 as a 10. So here the sum is 0 and carry is 1. Now add the next bit, that is 1 plus 1 plus 1. This is the last possibility where adder was 1, addend was 1, and the carry generated from previous operation was also 1. So here in this case we got the sum as a 11. So sum 2 will be 11. So now here consider this one as a sum of this addition and this one as a carry for next addition. So my sum will be 1 for this addition and carry will be 1 for the next bit addition. Now perform the MSG addition. So 1 plus 0 will be 1 over here and this 1 will be added with this carry 1. So I will get sum 3 as a 1 0. The 0 has a sum over here and 1 is the carry for next bit addition, but there are no bits. So there is no next addition. So just consider this carry as a sum over here. So this is my final result. Now let's move forward. Let's see how to perform multi number addition with carry. So I have arranged the equation in vertical manner so that it will be easy for you to understand. Here I have two addends, addend 1 and addend 2. You can have multiple addends. Let's start with the addition. So my adder is 110.0 over here. I have considered the fractional binary number so that the fractional binary addition will be clear to you as well. My addend is 011.1 and my next addend is 111.1. And I will add the carry generated from previous operation over here. And thus I will get a sum over here. So let's start with the fractional part addition. That is 0 plus 1 plus 1. We will call it as a sum 0. So 0 plus 1 is equal to 1 and that 1 plus 1 is equal to 1 0. So sum 0 I should get 1 0. Now consider this 0 as a sum of this addition. And this one as a carry for next addition. Now perform the next bit addition. Now this 1 plus 1 plus 1 I should get 1 1. So sum 1 I will get 1 1 over here. Now consider this one as a sum of this addition and this one as a carry for next addition. Now we have 4 bit addition. We have seen 3 bit addition on the previous slide. Now we have to perform 4 bit addition. How will you perform? See here, if this digit would have in decimal number system, then 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 4. So here our result should be binary equivalent of 4 decimal, and binary equivalent of 4 decimal is 100. So my sum 2 should be 100. Now here this 0 will be the sum of this addition and this 0 will be the carry for next bit addition and this one will be the carry for again next bit addition. So I will place over here. Now perform the next bit addition, that is 1 plus 0 plus 1 plus 0. Here I will get 1 plus 0 is equal to 1, 1 plus 1 is equal to 1 0, 1 0 plus 0 is equal to 1 0. So sum I will get here as 1 0. So here this 0 has a sum and this one is a carry for next addition. So I have considered 1 over here. Now in next bit addition there are no bits, but we have carries. So just add these 2 carries. So 1 plus 1 we will get 1 0. So put 1 0 over here. So this will be my final sum. This is how we perform binary addition. Thank you.